In these final 2 weeks, Hillary Clinton is leading in most of the states that will decide the presidential election. But in the one state that nearly always gets it right, she is in a dead heat with Donald Trump. We decided to ask Ohio what it thought, because Ohio has picked the winner in every election since 1964, and no Republican has ever won without Ohio. All of the issues converge on the Buckeye State, especially foreign trade, which is undermining industry. Among the steel mills, suburbs, and inner city of Cleveland, we found a political identity crisis as the state that nearly always predicts the president becomes unpredictable. A job at the mill was a birthright in Lorain, Ohio for 121 years. In 1895, the spark of the American century ignited the blast furnace, and the plant, 2 miles long, forged the rails, the drilling pipe, the weapons, and the wonders of the 20th century.
Oh my, it was wonderful. We were making steel, we were making money.
Making steel was all Carlos Hernandez knew for 28 years. But 7 months ago, he and 542 others punched the clock for the last time as cheap Chinese steel helped silence the furnace in a new century that he fears may not be America's.
It was just a funeral procession coming out to the gate, knowing that you never was coming back. You know, we sacrificed time with our families to try to make this company succeed. And this is what it's come to, just a ghost town, just a rusted, empty, meaningless place right now.
The meaning of this election is chewed over at George's Family Restaurant, where the roof, there beyond the sign, hyphenates the name of the place into You Rant. And do they ever?
Trump, I don't trust him. Can you imagine if he's the president of the United States, what he's going to do behind closed doors? With women, with his secretaries, or his, you know.
You mean like Bill Clinton did?
It's done and over with. Why do you keep bringing it up?
Carlos for Trump and Audi for Clinton have been married 36 years. They're hoping for 37.
I'm sorry I wasn't there when you two sat down together to watch the first debate.
Oh, we could have sat together.
No.
No.
I go in front of the
and
TV.
Then we come back and forth and argue.
You couldn't watch the debate together?
No.
Carlos and Audi are raising 2 grandchildren. He's on unemployment, but they're going broke slowly on her fast food salary.
It just shows how we're losing our jobs, how things are moving away. You know, everybody's saying about how illegal aliens are coming in and taking our jobs and stuff like that. Well, the jobs are moving. They don't need to come here anymore. Jobs are going to them.
And so when you hear Donald Trump saying the same thing about jobs, what do you think?
Well, that's what resonates with me, what he has to say.
But it doesn't with Audi.
Why not?
He's talking
about bringing the steel industry back, bringing the coal industry back. Stop those jobs from going to Mexico.
That's what he says. I just don't trust him. I don't like him. I don't believe in him at all.
When you hear Donald Trump say those things that he said on that videotape about women, How do you get past that? How can you get past that?
It's awful what he said, but I come from a steel industry. We all say things that we wouldn't be proud of saying in front of other people. But he didn't say it to him. He was talking with another guy. It was words. It wasn't action.
Audi, do you feel the same way?
No, I do not. Trump is a liar, number one. Number two, he's constantly on Hillary about Bill Clinton. And Bill Clinton is not running for president. Another thing they were passed, and we should just forget about it, is the whole email thing. It's done and over. She apologized, it's done. Just move on.
But I
let you talk.
But the text of the speeches that she gave to Wall Street high rollers, and she said, well, you know, in this world you have to have a public position and you have to have a private position. Mm-hmm. That feeds into that sense that many people have that she's not trustworthy.
I believe in her. I do. Compared to him, that he's so such a pig, because to me he's a pig.
This is Ohio in a Buckeye.